Molly. I wanted to share a bit of my new yoga practice. I'm doing a slow and steady, and I've been talking to a few friends and trying to work out like how to share and help other people who are intimidated by yoga to come into it. So, mid-50s, in my 20s, 30s, super fit, super mobile, flexible, everything, doing everything.
Great.
30s, yes. 40s, not so much. 50s have been kind of a physical shit show, should we say. Oh, and here's the dog. Hi, be helping. So Billie's going to help because she likes to do downward dog and upward dog with me and everything else. And so the slow and steady series, I figured, would be one way for me to track my progress and also my progress as I'm learning to become a yoga teacher. So I'm coming in at 55 and I really... not in a great place physically. The last couple of years I've been flat on my back a bunch, back issues, hip issues. They wanted to do surgery. I don't want to do surgery. So I'm doing anything and everything I can to not go that way. So one thing I wanted to start with was, if you stick with me and you come along with some of these things, is that the breath work, it's, for me it's meditation in motion. So it's going inside. And so when I'm doing poses and holding different asanas, I'm holding them for 30 seconds on average, you know, once I've gone through them a few times, and I'll show you the different breath patterns, and then I hold them for 30 seconds, and I really pay attention from my toes up, or from my head down, and just check in with my toes, my feet, the bottom of my feet, the top of my feet, my ankles, and just work my way up my body, and then I'll slowly move and transition into the next asana, the next pose, posture. And so one thing I do like to do is in the mornings, I start with a little loosening process. And again, it's really just a way of me getting back into my body and breathing before I start going out into the world and doing my thing. So I thought I would share that with you today. So let's see, make sure you can see me. At least you can see some. So to start with, feet together underneath and just stand up straight and notice... I try to notice when I'm tilting, because I tend to tilt, this side comes out. So I have to readjust myself a little, shoulders back, hands just loose. And then I start with my head, and I'm just breathing in and out slowly, circling my head a few times. Breathe in and out. In. And out. And I feel the muscles all the way different sides of my neck as I do that. It's not much, just a little, and then the other direction. In and out. In and out. And as I do that, I can feel how my body is moving from my knees and my butt. So back to center. So I do that usually 5 or 10 of each, and then I also turn to the left and the right. I breathe in, look over my shoulder. Notice if you're twisting, well, I'm twisting, try not to, and breathe out to the front. In, hold it, and out. In, out, in, out. Then I do a little shoulder rolls, just tiny. All of these are just little, nothing stretch, nothing like hypermobile, just loosening up one direction about 5 or 10 times, and then rolling your shoulders the other direction. And again, just noticing everything in your body. Another one is arms out. It's a pose you'll use a lot in yoga, or I use a lot in yoga. But this, is, again, is just a little loosening up the joints. In one direction. Notice your body and your knees and your butt. Extend your hands. And then the other direction. Another one is to lift your arms up. If you can, pull them together. Place your hands and just stretch yourself up. You'll feel it on the side body, in your stomach, actually in your bum. And come up. you look up, you feel it even more. It feels really nice. Another one, I like this just to open up the side. Again, simple little movements. Hold and in and out. Do those a few times. Now, taking your feet apart a little bit, trust me, they're apart. You want to just twist sideways. So back and back and in and breathe out. And breathe in and breathe out. Another nice little one for your hips and your lower back is just a little, again, micro movements of just turning around. I think you can see. Let's check. Sure. Little micro movements, so in all the directions. And breathing in, going forward, breathing out, going back. Doing that different directions. Do that for a little bit. I'm doing a shorter version of the video. Another one is lifting your knee up, and you'll feel it here and around your lower back. It's also good for balance and stability, which I really want to work on myself. So holding that and then turning it around. I'll show you sideways, which will lead in later to a different pose. Posture, but you'll feel it here and here. And again, just breathing in and out for a few seconds and letting it go. Same with the next leg, the opposite one. This is a little harder for me. You'll notice like one hip might be different to the other. And I feel it here and I feel it here. So up. And then your balance isn't good, you can just use a wall. A chair, and this, I feel it in my thigh. You kind of notice if you're bending over, which I just was, standing up straight a little bit, and see how your other foot is doing. If you're a little wobbly, you can use a wall, or you can focus on something about the same height as your eyes, is 10, 20 feet away, and that usually helps. Breathe out, and then, not that you'll see, but I do lift my foot up and just loosen my ankles, left and right, circles, micro movements. Again, even though this is so small, you're also working on stability because your other leg is holding you. So, loosening up the feet, jiggle, jiggle. And then, last one is just a little, you know, extend that way, stretch forward, your heel, your toe, heel, and you'll feel it all the way down your leg. I actually feel it here too. I'm a little wobbly on this. Toe, heel, toe, as much as you like. And then the last one, a lot of people are a little dubious about the whole bending forward and all that. So I'll just show you what different ways. Breathe in, your arms up. Breathe out halfway. Breathe in and just hold it, and then just let yourself fold, whatever that means to you. Maybe you have a dog to lean on. It always helps to have a dog to lean on. She's very helpful. And some people might be able to go all the way down, bend your knees, and just enjoy the stretch in your back. And as you come back up, people worry about that, bend your knees forward. Just slow and steady up. And a nice stretch. And that's a great way to start your day and start your practice. So there you go. There's some ideas to start with, and we'll take it from there. Okay?